This video has been created thanks to MyWorld, a consortium programme fuelling the west of England's creative technology sector and funded by UK Research and Innovation Strength in Places Fund. This video will guide you through how to build the Red V-RAPTOR. The Red V-RAPTOR is the first of the DSM C3 generation cameras and uses a new VistaVision sensor which can shoot 8K full frame with up to 120 frames per second. It can shoot 4K up to 240 frames per second, 2K up to 480 frames per second, and captures 17 plus stops of dynamic range. It uses updated Red Code RAW settings, HQ, MQ and LQ, has a customizable OLED display, a 7-inch LCD touch monitor, and uses the CF Express Type B memory cards. It includes a RF lens mount with locking mechanism, a micro V mount battery plate, a 60mm fan for quieter and more stable heat management, and wireless connectivity via the FreeRed Control app. To get started, turn the camera body over. There are two 3/8 screw threads which align with the two screws on the Arca Swiss plate. When attaching the Arca plate, make sure the front of the plate is facing the front of the camera. Click the Arca plate into position. Use the Allen key provided to tighten the screws into the camera base. Ensure the front of the quick release base plate is facing the front of the camera. Unlock the quick release lever in the direction of the plate you are attaching. Slide the quick release plate onto the Arca plate and lock into position. Using the two 3/8 screws, attach the short dovetail mounting plate to the wooden camera unified bridge plate and tighten using a screwdriver. With the short dovetail plate facing upwards, unlock the lever on the unified bridge plate, push the catch down on the long dovetail mounting plate, slide the bridge plate on and lock into position. Unlock the release lever on the quick release base plate and slide onto the unified bridge plate until it clicks and lock into position. Unlock the wing nut levers on the unified bridge plate and slide the 19mm rods into position and lock into place. Attach the first wing grip to the side of the camera and tighten the captive screws with the Allen key. Rotate the tripod by releasing the pan locking mechanism and attach the second wing grip to the other side. Ensure both groups of pins on the base of the small HD monitor and the camera are aligned. Use the Allen key to tighten the screws. On the top handle, note that it features a start-stop record button. Make sure the pins and screws are aligned and attach the top handle to the base of the monitor using the Allen key. Connect one end of the USB-C cable to the monitor base and the other end to the bottom of the monitor. You can attach the dual XLR adapter to any of the 3/8 insert threads found around the camera. Tighten the screw with the Allen key. Connect the 5-pin LiMo cable from the XLR adapter to the audio input on the back of the camera. Ensure the red dot at the end of the LiMo cable is aligned to the red dot on the audio input to prevent damage to the pins. attach the expander blade to the EXT port on the camera, and secure the captive screws to the back and side of the ARCA plate. On the camera RF lens mount, unlock the front ring and push the right-hand side button to release the cap. Connect the PL mount by aligning the orange dot with the red dot and twist to the right until it clicks into position. It is important to attach the lens support to the 19mm rods to help support the weight of the lens. This is to prevent damage to the lens mount and to prevent vibration during filming. Place the lens support onto the rods. Unlock the lever to find the correct alignment of the spigot and lock into position. Remove the PL mount cap and insert the lens, making sure the pins and screws are aligned. Rotate the lens mount retaining ring to the right to secure the lens. Hold the lens with your hand until the lens support is tightened. And lock into place. Attach the V-lock battery to the back of the camera. Press the Access Media button to open the card slot and insert the memory card. Switch the camera on and you're ready to start filming.